Hey, how's it going, brothers and sisters? Welcome to November. All right. Hey, guess what? I've got some black coffee. I'm on a fast. It's Monday. And I've got some clown online that's chirping at my wife and chirping at me about something I post in social media. So it's time to rant and blaze. All right. Working on this doobie. And as you can see, I've got another doobie on deck because, well, I'm going to try to make this short and sweet. So let's just get a little cool motivation happening for the fat fuck that I'm going to unleash my fury on in this rant and blaze. So sit back, get it ready, and let's get at it.
I stay hungry all the time so that I'm not scared of shit. I ain't scared of fucking haters, okay? People that can't handle hate won't amount to shit. I ain't scared of anything. Anything to do with people that fucking come and attack me and fucking this fear of judgment. I don't care. I don't fucking care.
I gotta tell you, I love Cole's attitude, man. And when I'm dealing with some individuals that are like this motherfucker right here, this is a fella by the name of Doug Grittner, and he's a fat fuck. Hey, you know I calls it like I sees it. If you're fat, you're a fat fuck. If you're lazy, you're a lazy fuck. Come on, if you're stupid, you're just a stupid fuck. Hey, am I lying? No, I'm not. I'm just, like I said, calls it like I sees it. So, Doug Grittner of Alexis Creek has gotten my attention. He owns Doug's Repair in Alexis Creek, and I will extrapolate on Doug's Repair after we get into the meat and potatoes of this here rant and blaze. But last week, on social medias, on the Facebook Zombieland, there is a community board called the Tatla, blah, 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 blah. Anyways, this community board had a post by a lady that had the unfortunate displeasure of stopping at Doug's Repair. Now, this is not a one-off of what I'm about to share with you, and this is fucking, yeah, you're going to love this fucker. So Doug's Repair, has a reputation of being a little irascible at times. Say you're driving along Highway 20, and maybe you've got a leak in your tire. Maybe you want to stop and get some air, and there's really no, you know, service stations. You come into Alexis Creek, and there's Doug's Repair. It is a little garage. Operated by Doug Grittner. He is an unlicensed mechanic, but he does have mechanical skills and aptitude. But with that, he's got a huge fucking chip on his shoulder. He's a bit of a cunt. Hey, if that word offends you, I'm sorry, that's just too bad, but I calls it like I sees it. He is a cunt. Because on this particular day, last week at the end of October, an elderly lady, a 68-year-old lady, stopped in because her little tire thing was going off, little tire pressure sensor in her vehicle. She stopped in and she asked for some help, and this fucking piece of shit basically went off on her, calling her stupid, calling her a stupid bitch that she didn't know how to read a tire gauge. Are you shocked by this? Don't be shocked, because he's done this many, many times. So on this post on social media, I saw this post by this woman, and there's other people giving their own, I guess, examples of interacting with Doug and the piece of work that he is, and I basically stated my opinion. I would love to share the content with you, but it is gone. It got removed. But it was along the lines of, unfiltered, calls it like I sees it. He is a POS, piece of shit. He is misogynistic, he is racist, and during the 2017 wildfires, his business did quite well financially. That's all I said. I spoke the truth, because he is a racist. My wife and I had the advent of spending some time with him and his father when his father was alive in the garage, having a casual interaction, a visit back after we first moved out here. We didn't know a lot of people. And we sat there and listened to these people just rip into every ethnic group, as well as gossip and talk shit about pretty much every other person in the Chacolton that they knew or interacted with. It was like, wow, what an eye-opener. The example I gave you of the lady, that has happened a myriad of times over the years. This fucking piece of shit has had the foresight to, on social media from time to time, post different things of somebody coming in. And when I call this guy a fucking cop caller, he is. Because this woman, he charged $10. And she was like, I'm not going to pay you $10 for fucking checking my tire, for tire pressure. He called the RCMP. in Alexis Creek there, St. Peter's probably 300 or 400 feet down the road from his shop, he has called the cops before on someone who did not want to pay a $2 air charge because he charges $2 for air. He has had people stop in and want to talk to him and make an appointment for a actual vehicular issue that they're having right then and there that's affecting them to be able to operate their vehicle. And he's like, well, why don't you just fuck off and make an appointment for next week? Hi, I'm driving to town now. My vehicle's broke down in front of your garage and you want me to call you next week and make a fucking... So I'm looking at some stuff from 2017 when he networked with some folks. We were getting aid to the base. It was coming in military helicopters and it was being taken to Redstone, to the reserve. He networked with some folks and they had some stuff sent to Alexis Creek for all the people in that area. So that is white and indigenous. As well as, at the point in time, Interior Roads, their yard, had some supplies brought too. These folks went from where they had their own stash up to the other stash for handout for people and took some of that stuff as well. Fucking stockpiling. And yet, here's this post. I'm looking at it right here. Remembering 2017, we were a very small part of a much bigger picture. From aid station to special fabrication, we kept 500 vehicles running well, while all others closed and abandoned the Chilcotin. They made a lot of money. They made enough money during those wildfires. Well, everyone else abandoned the Chilcotin, but they were able to buy more properties. Anyways, this piece of shit ends up contacting my wife. I will throw these screenshots into here for you now. So as you see, he contacted my wife and wanted to know if I was her husband. And she responded by saying, yeah, what's the point? He's like, well, why is he doing this and why is he doing that? And I've said, this is the reason why I posted on social media. You want to act like that? Then get called out for your behavior like that. She basically said to him that, he made that comment. She doesn't control what I say. And if you have a problem with him, take it up with him. And what's he do? He comes back at her again going, blah, 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 blah. And the last part, if he has something to say to me, to grow a set and stop at any time. All right. Her response was, I could say the same thing to you. Grow a set, as this has nothing to do with me. And it was not me that said anything, so take it up with him. So what does this guy do? He's chirping at my wife. He doesn't send me a message on Facebook. He doesn't send Chili Boo a message to go, hey, why are you talking shit on me? Why are you slamming my business? Wah, wah, wah. All right, cue Cole. Bam!
Wah! Wah!
Wah, wah. Yeah, like I fucking said. Call me. You know what my phone number is. You can message me on Facebook, but you don't. You're a fucking bitch. Grow a set. So, what did I do? I called him this morning after seeing this interaction with my wife and her responding to him accordingly, saying, hey, deal with fucking him. And I said, hey, Doug, this is what I said, and this is why I said it. You are racist. The guy gets banned on Facebook all the time for posting shit because he is so anti-Muslim, it's not funny. Like, everyone's going to have their opinions about different people and all that, and you see different facets of racism. You see reverse racism when you live in an environment where you, like we are here, whites are a minority. You feel the reverse racism from the native community that has a long-standing dislike for whites. But I digress. I'm not out there. Other people aren't out there. Some people are stupid enough to be online chirping away and fucking hate, 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 hate. No, 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 no. Like I've said in the past, we're all not going to fucking hold hands and sing Kumbaya. The planet was never like that. It's not supposed to be like that. That is not natural. Not for us as a species and not in nature. Things don't fucking just get along and skip through the forest holding hands. No, but I digress. I'm going off on a tangent. Told you, I'm on a fast. I'm drinking coffee. We're breezing. Let up. We're ranting. Basically said in my phone message, hey man, stop fucking chirping at my wife. Grow a set. You want to talk to me, you can get a hold of me. You want me to come down to Alexis Creek and talk to you? No, I'm not going to waste my time because you're a fucking cop caller and that's what he is. So I'm not saying nothing here, nudge, nudge, wink, wink, but hey, if you're having a slow day, you can check out this piece of shit for yourself. There's no need to bring my name or bring my wife's good name into it. I'm just bringing it to your attention, and hey, this is how I'm dealing with it as a coping mechanism. It's a little bit of rant and blaze. As well, I got my big monkey brother coming over in a few hours. We're going to go do a workout called Monkey See, Monkey Do. We might videotape that for you. And if you haven't seen it already, Breaking Buds dropped another episode. This time, it's the Papaya OG from Liberty Farms. In that video, I made a mistake of saying Lindsay Farms because I was getting a little bit of... I was getting lit like that rainbow sock monkey back there. All right. Thanks for playing along at home. Hope you have a beauty day. Remember, pay it forward, random acts of kindness. But call those pieces of shit out there for what they are. Take care of yourself. We'll see you next time. Peace.
Eine halbe Tasse Schnaps.